Yes, Chaitanya, good morning. Ajinkya, good morning. Rishikesh Thupe, turn on your video. Ashutosh, turn on your video. Good morning, Atharva. Nobody's turning on their video. What happened? Can you all hear me properly? Ayush, am I audible beta?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. Thank you. All right, so let's start. Good morning, everyone. Welcome back to another English class. Hope you all are doing good. Today we will be dealing with comprehensional exercises, okay? Because I can see most of you cannot unmute your mic or say the answers and all. I'm speaking ke liye, it is very necessary. So I thought when we meet in person, I hope you are coming here soon. Are you?
I am.
Kya beta? Audio. Hi, Rameshwar. Good morning.
Good morning, ma'am.
Yeah. So I was saying that speaking ke liye and I need people to speak. So when people cannot speak, I cannot conduct speaking classes. So I thought I'll take the comprehension today. So soon we will be meeting, hopefully. Shall we meet, hopefully? Are we meeting?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you guys coming?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So at that time, we will take more of the communication sessions. So today, I'll be sharing with you the comprehension. Okay, Ayush. All right. Okay. Okay. So today, we will be seeing the comprehensions. Comprehension is a very common topic. Most of you must be knowing because in your smaller classes, as part of writing skills, it is always there. You were supposed to read a paragraph and you need to answer. So when you come to an NDA point of view, it's not going to be as simple as it used to be in your school days. For example, in your smaller classes, even in your first standard, second standard, you do comprehension. In a town, there live Ramu and his brother Shamu. So the comprehension question will be, what is Ramu's brother name? So you will write Shamu. Hey. So that is your very small class's comprehension. So you cannot expect something that like that. Here, more or less, you need to understand the concept in that comprehension. The meaning, what that comprehension is about. That is why I always ask you to read newspapers, read English articles, stuff, to know that underlying meaning rather than the word meaning. If you go word by word meaning, you will not understand the concept. Ab comprehend karna hai. Wo paragraph ka matlab kya hai, wo samajh mein aana hai. Okay? Then only you can answer. So in your NDA competitive exam also, you will get comprehensions of obviously only for MCQ answers. From the comprehension, a question will be asked, four options will be given, and you need to correct the select the correct option. So today we will try some comprehensions like that. I request all of you to please take your notebook and pen and be ready. I'll share the screen and the passage will be popped up and you can go through it. I'll read it for you once and I'll make others also read. Then I'll give you a time for silent reading and you need to note down the answer in your notebook. Questions will be there in the screen. Okay, ready? Shall we?
All right. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Okay, I'll start with paragraph Can you all see the screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So if I zoom it like this, I think it's more clear for you, right? Now you all can see passage one a little more clear, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Okay, so passage one has three questions. Four questions. Let's go through the passage first. I'll just read out for you. Why am I reading? Not to show that I can read, but anybody who feels difficult to pronounce any words or feels it difficult to understand any word, for them I'm reading. So be very careful while I'm reading and listen to it. Passage one. Modern economic theory does not differentiate between renewable and non-renewable materials, as its approach is to measure everything by means of a money price. Thus, taking various alternative fuels like coal, oil, wood, and water power, the only difference between them recognized by modern economics is relative cost per equivalent unit. The cheapest is automatically the one to be preferred, as to do otherwise would be irrational and uneconomic. From a Buddhist point of view, of course, this will not do, since the essential difference between non-renewable fuels like coal and oil on the one hand and renewable sources like wind power and water power on the other cannot be simply overlooked. Non-renewable goods must be used only if their use is indispensable, and then only with the greatest care and highest concern for conservation. To use them carelessly or extravagantly is an act of violence, and while complete non-violence may not be possible on this earth, it is nonetheless a duty of man to aim at the ideal of non-violence in all he does. Okay, I'm sure that most of you will not be, you know, very clear about what we have just learned. Some people must have understood up 15 to 20%, but it is about, at least this is about renewable and non-renewable resources and its impact, economical impact. Okay, so I want you to, one or two persons needs to be Ashutosh, can you please read it better? Ashutosh.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, read it better.
Okay.
Everybody listen in between. I'll ask Ashutosh to stop and I'll ask other person to continue. At that time, everybody must be following the same. Yeah, start, Ashutosh.
Passage one. Modern economic theory does not differentiate between renewable and non-renewable materials. As speeds, madam, what is that?
Approach.
Nee. Uske pehle.
As its approach, correct? Aapne read
kiya. As its approach is to measure everything by means of a money price. Thus, taking various alternative fuels like coal, oil, wood, and water power, the only difference between them recognized by modern economics is relative cost per equivalent unit. The cheapest is automatically the one to be preferred, as to otherwise would be irrational and uneconomic. From a Buddhist point of view, of course, this will not be, since the essential difference between non-renewable fuels like coal and oil on the one hand, renewable sources like wind power and water power on the other cannot be simply overlooked.
Okay, beta, thank you.
Non-renewable.
Rameshwar?
Yes, ma'am. Non-renewable goods must be used only if their use is indispensable, and then only with the greatest care and highest concern for extra
Conservation. You missed one line. Concern for conservation.
Conservation to use them carelessly or extravagantly in an act of violence, and while complete non-violence may not be possible on this earth, it is nonetheless a duty of man to aim at the ideal of non-violence in all he does.
Okay, thank you, beta. Next, Rishikesh Tupe, are you there in the class? Rishikesh Tupe, are you there? Okay, no reply. Chaitanya, are you there? Chaitanya Rahokle. Chaitanya? Okay, Chaitanya has some health problem. Then, Rishikesh Tupe, why are you not responding? Okay. Atharva Shalke, can you respond through audio? Atharva Shalke.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Atharva, can you please read better?
Ma'am, that question answers.
No, better. Same thing. We are reading it again and again. Modern economic theory, passage points.
Modern economic theory does not differentiate between renewable and non-renewable materials, as its approach is to measure everything by means of money price. Thus, taking various alternative fuels like coal, oil, wood, and water power, the only difference between them recognized by modern economics is relative cost per equivalent unit. The cheapest is automatically the one to be preferred, as to do otherwise would be irrational.
Beta, would be nahi hai, would be.
Otherwise would be irrational and economic from a Buddhist point of view. Of course, this will not do, since the essential difference between non-renewable fuels like coal and oil and on the one hand, and renewable resources like wind power and water power on the other cannot be simply overlooked. Non-renewable goods must be used only if their use is indispensable, and then only with the greatest care and highest concern for conservation. To use them carelessly or extravagantly in act of violence, and while complete non-violence may not be possible on this earth, It is nonetheless a duty of man to aim at the ideal non-violence in all he does.
Okay, thank you, Veta. The second thing I want you to do is, there are so many words which will not be familiar to you. I want you to write all the non-familiar words that you have come across this paragraph first. Start it now. Write it in your notebook. Don't just look at the screen and sit. Take your notebook. Write down all the words which are not familiar to you that you have come across in this paragraph. Start it right now. In another 5 minutes, I'll be stop sharing the screen and I will ask you to read out your words. All the words. Check line by line. Any words that you don't know, write it down. Aapko meaning samajh mein nahi aaya, write down such words. Pass.
Ma'am?
Yes?
That first paragraph, starting words are not clear.
Modern.
No, ma'am. Wo starting ke word hai na, ma'am. Sub line ke.
Okay, one is modern, second one is between, third is assets, third, fourth is of a, fifth is fuels, then difference, economics, cheapest, has to do, uneconomic, course, difference.
Yes, ma'am. Okay, so how many words have you taken? Okay, I can see Rishikesh Thupi, indispensable, extravagantly, nonetheless. Very good. Others, everyone can type it now in the chat. Fast, everybody has to, even though your mic is not working, you can do this. So everybody has to do that. I mean, not the number, just type down your words fast, beta. Rishikesh has given it to me like that. Everyone type it out fast, fast.
Okay. Thank you, Ashutosh. Thank you, Rameshwar. I'm getting words. What are others doing? Only three people are there in my class. Others, I'm giving you last 2 minutes. Type it out fast. The words that you have not find it. If you say that you have no doubts, then I'll ask all the words meaning. Okay. Thank you for all that you have, all those who have sent messages saying that some words are, most of the words that you said you didn't know is common. Thank you, Atharva. Yeah. Extravagantly means lavishly. Write down in your notebook first. Extravagant means he spends extravagantly, means lavishly. Okay. Extravagant means lavish. Hope you all know what lavish means.
No, ma'am.
No?
No.
No.
Oh, my God. Lavishly means Amir log paisa bahut lavish spend karte.
Ma'am, bahut kharcha karna.
What, beta?
Bahut kharcha karna.
I didn't hear it, Atharva. What is it?
Ma'am, bahut sara kharcha karna.
Ah, bahut zyada kharcha karna. That's called lavish or extravagant. Kharcha bahut karte. Aise paisa kya bolte. They will just spend their money just like that. Spending money without any thought. Not just money, anything. Spending without much thought. Can it be water, resources, anything we are spending bahut zyada, isko bolte extravagant. Abhi samajh mein aaya? Okay. The next question that next word you all have asked is indispensable means absolutely necessary. Samajh mein aaya na? Absolutely necessary. Indispensable means absolutely necessary. I'm writing it in the chat, so nobody should miss it. Absolutely necessary. Next word you all have asked is irrational. Irrational matlab without any logic. Doesn't make any sense bolte hai na hum. That is called irrational. Mara certain things doesn't make any sense. That is called irrational. Then somebody has asked for the meaning overlook. I overlooked my mom's illness, matlab failed to notice. Some people will wrongly understand this meaning as bahut zyada look karte. No, overlook matlab fail to notice. Don't overlook the situation, it might happen to you again. Abhi aapne problem nahi hai aise fail to notice सिचुएशन बाद में बहुत ज्यादा प्रॉब्लम होता है. सो ओवरलुक मीन्स नॉट लुकिंग सो मच, इट्स जस्ट ऑपोजिट, फेल टू नोटिस. रिकग्नाइज्ड मीन्स अप्रोच. अप्रोच मीन्स हम कैसे अप्रोच करते हैं, मीन्स उसके पास जाता है. ओके, दैट इज कॉल्ड अप्रोच. नॉनदलेस, नॉनदलेस मीन्स नेवरदलेस. Nevertheless, nonetheless are the words which we use to, we use the word, no, anyways, hai na? Like that we use the words nonetheless or nevertheless. Anyways ka meaning kya hai? Bahut sara waise hai nahi hai na? Anyways, in spite of, that is the meaning of nonetheless or nevertheless. Anyways jaisa meaning. All right, so we have discussed almost all the difficult words. Now we will start discussing about the passage. So what is this passage all about? What is your understanding about this passage? Did you understand something? What is your understanding? I would love to hear that. Ramesh, you start.
Ma'am, I got that the non-renewable and renewable sources, which they told by different point of view, by the Buddhist and the modern scientist, yeah, modern whatever that is. So they showed point of view of that, and they best comprehends that non-renewable.
Okay, thank you. I understood what you're trying to say. In between it was working. So I'll just say, everybody knows what renewable and what non-renewable resources are. You are learning this in your science subject from fifth standard. Resources that can be used lavishly because it can be renewed again and again, like water. Yeah, in Aurangabad, water is not renewable. I'm just taking a general context. Something like water, something like soil, we can get it so much. But what about petrol? Why petrol is going or having a high price? Because it is not existing that much in the interior of the earth. It can run out any day. Run out matlab khatam ho jata hai. Okay, such resources are known as, yeah, resources means naturally it is there, lekin wo resources ek din khatam hona wala hai, itna zyada uska source nahi hai. Aise resources ko hum bana bhi nahi sakte. Aise resources ko hum bolte hain non renewable resources, which cannot be renewed again and again. Lekin renewable resources se ha bahut zyada hum wapas milte hain. That is called renewable and non-renewable. So it is said that economist ko kya hai? Economist ko ye preserve karna, usko samrakshan karna, dekhbhal karna, wo ichha nahi hai. Wo sab monetary benefits mein dekhta hai. Monetary benefits mein, haan, agar per unit ka price kitna hai, wo hai. Isliye hum aisa. Petrol ka price bahut zyada hai. Kyun? Uska demand bahut zyada hai. Bahut logon ko gaadi hai. So, बहुत लोगों को पेट्रोल चाहिए, so उसका यूनिट प्राइस ऐसे सोच करते हैं, लेकिन सच में कैसे सोच करना है? हमारा अर्थ में इतना ज्यादा नहीं है, इसलिए हम बहुत ध्यान से उसको यूज करना है. Not because its price is more than 100, because it's a renewable resources, you should be very careful in using petrol and diesel. So this is your attitude, not just monetary value. लेकिन हम ये नहीं, कभी भी नहीं सकते, इंक्लूडिंग नहीं, कभी भी नहीं सकते. हम क्यों पेट्रोल को कम करते? अभी 103 तक हो गया पर लीटर. इसलिए आर वी एनी एटलीस्ट वंस आर वी थिंकिंग, अरे ये भूमि के अंदर अभी नहीं है, एक दिन आने वाला है, ये पूरा खत्म होने वाला है, उस दिन हम क्या करेंगे? इसलिए हम, मेरी तरफ से एक ड्रॉप है तो मैं सेव करूंगी, ऐसा हम कभी नहीं सोचेंगे. आज मैं गाड़ी नहीं लेने वाला है क्योंकि अभी 103 तक हो गया, सो हम पैदल जाते हैं. पैदल जाना अच्छा है, लेकिन हमारा एटीट्यूड क्या होना है? नॉट बिकॉज ऑफ द प्राइस, बिकॉज ऑफ माय मनी, बिकॉज दिस इज अ रिन्यूएबल रिसोर्सेस, वी आर प्रोटेक्टिंग अर्थ और दिस रिसोर्स फ्रॉम डिप्लीशन. सो दैट शुड बी, सो दैट इज व्हाट बुद्धिस्ट इज सेइंग, दैट वी शुड नॉट ओवरलुक इट. व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय ओवरलुक? फेल टू नोटिस. अर्थ में क्या होने वाला है? दिस पेट्रोल का रिसोर्स कम होने वाला है, दिस हाँ किसी भी हो, ऐसा नहीं करना है, ओवरलुक नहीं करना है. वी शुड बी वेरी केयरफुल इन यूजिंग आवर रिसोर्सेस. दिस इज व्हाट द बुद्धिस्ट सेज. लेकिन द अदर इकोनॉमिस्ट क्या बोलता है? इकोनॉमिस्ट यूनिट प्राइस के बारे में वो बहुत सोच करता है. सो दिस इज, बट एनीवेज वी हैव टू बी वेरी केयरफुल अबाउट यूजिंग रिन्यूएबल नॉन रिन्यूएबल रिसोर्सेस. एंड रिन्यूएबल रिसोर्स को हम अच्छा से यूज करना है, उसको यू शुड मेक इट इनटू यूज. ओके, स्टोर करना है विंड एनर्जी से और ज्यादा प्रोडक्शन होना है, ये सब इस्तेमाल करना है. वेयर एज नॉन रिन्यूएबल रिसोर्सेस को हम थोड़ा सा ये करके प्रिजर्व करके यूज करना है. सो दैट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस पैराग्राफ. नाउ लेट्स गेट इनटू द क्वेश्चंस. लेट्स सी, नाउ दैट यू हैव दिस नॉलेज, हाउ विल यू आंसर द क्वेश्चन, और लेट्स लुक एट द type of questions you will get based on this paragraph. All right, so let's look at question number one. Can somebody read that question? Who can read? Nobody's responding here today.
Ma'am, may I?
Yes, Brenda.
Which of the following statements are correct on the basis of information in the above passage? First, Buddhist economists totally prohibit the use of non-renewable sources. Second, the attitude of modern economics towards natural resources is uneconomic. Third, complete non-violence is not possible.
Okay.
Select the correct answer.
Okay, better.
Using
the Ramesha, thank you. Yeah. See, now I want you to concentrate on the questions here. ये देखो क्या प्रकार का questions मिलते हैं आपको, हाँ? You have read a paragraph and I have told you the overall idea about that paragraph. We have even discussed the words. Now they are asking you about which is the correct information. ऐसे एक question आपको जरूर मिलते हैं हर कॉम्प्रिहेंशन से. इस कॉम्प्रिहेंशन से क्या करेक्ट है क्या करेक्ट नहीं है. उधर बेसिकली व्हाट यू नीड टू लुक आउट देयर इज उन्होंने एनीथिंग दैट इज आउट ऑफ द पैराग्राफ पूछते हैं तो यू हैव टू इग्नोर इट. ओके, दैट इज पॉइंट नंबर वन, आउट ऑफ द पैराग्राफ. पॉइंट नंबर टू, एनी पॉइंट्स व्हिच आर डिस्टॉर्टेड. डिस्टॉर्टेड मतलब exactly ऐसा नहीं बोला लेकिन वो ऐसे बोल रहे, ऐसा वाला पॉइंट्स को भी हम वेरी केयरफुली वी नीड टू डील विद इट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल लुक एट द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन. उन्होंने थ्री स्टेटमेंट्स इधर दिया. एक स्टेटमेंट ऐसा टेक्स्ट में से है बराबर. ओके, विच इज दैट स्टेटमेंट, वो फाइंड करना है. लेट्स गो टू द फर्स्ट स्टेटमेंट. बुद्धिस्ट इकोनॉमिस्ट totally prohibit the use of non-renewable resources. First statement bol rahe ki Buddhist economists harm non-renewable resources like coal, petrol, ye bilkul use nahi karna hai, aise bol rahe. Unhone aise bola hai kya? Bilkul use hi nahi karna hai, aisa bola hai kya? Atharva?
No ma'am.
Atharva? Anybody said like that? Buddhist economists ne kya bola? Hum bahut careful hona hai, aisa hi bola. Lekin statement kya hai? Prohibit means मना किया. सो दैट इज नॉट अ करेक्ट सेंटेंस अकॉर्डिंग टू द पैराग्राफ. लेट्स कम टू द सेकंड स्टेटमेंट. द एटीट्यूड ऑफ मॉडर्न इकोनॉमिस्ट टुवर्ड्स नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज इज अनइकोनॉमिक. अरे मॉडर्न इकोनॉमिक्स, हम टू ग्रुप के बारे में इधर बोला, बुद्धिस्ट और मॉडर्न इकोनॉमिक्स. मॉडर्न इकोनॉमिक्स हर चीज के लिए पैसे के बारे में बिल्कुल नहीं सोचते. That is opposite, है ना? Their every decision is economic, monetary value के based है उनका सब decisions and सब attitude. So that is something which is opposite to what we have read in paragraph. So which is not correct. So both the sentences are not correct. Come to the third one. Complete non-violence is not possible. If you see the last sentence. Just go through the last paragraph. Non-renewable goods must be used only if their use is indispensable. Indispensable means absolutely necessary and only with the greatest care and highest concern for conservation. So, बहुत ध्यान से, protection से हम use करना है. To use them carelessly or extravagantly, अगर आप वो carelessly और बहुत खर्चा से करते हैं तो it can be an act of violence. Violence मतलब क्या है? Act of violence मतलब क्या है? When you kill someone, when you do something really bad, that is called violently. One, when you torture someone or when you beat someone, that is all violence. Okay, so making or harming something is known as violence. So agar aap ye resources barabar nahi use karte hai to bhi wo bhi ek act of violence jaisa hai. Hum kisi ko maar dalte nahi hai lekin hum kisi ko ye nahi karte, lekin agar aap wo kuch nahi karte lekin resources ko aap barabar nahi use karte hai to आप एक वायलेंस करना जैसा है. टू यूज देम केयरलेसली और एक्सट्रावेजेंटली इज एन एक्ट ऑफ वायलेंस. एंड व्हाइल कंप्लीट नॉन वायलेंस मे नॉट बी पॉसिबल ऑन दिस अर्थ, सो इसलिए मैं कल से बिल्कुल पेट्रोल नहीं यूज करते, ये बोलना पॉसिबल नहीं है. सो कंप्लीट नॉन वायलेंस इज नॉट पॉसिबल. Anyways, duty of a man is ideal of non-violence is all dealers. लेकिन control करना है. So complete non-violence in this case मतलब क्या है? Yeah, using petrol and coal is बहुत harmful है, violence जैसा है. इसलिए मैं कल से वो complete मैंने avoid करेंगे. Is it possible? No, it's not possible. So complete non-violence is not possible. So that is one statement which is in the text. Now come to the third option. Complete non-violence is not possible. So that is something this paragraph says and which is true. Okay? So option 3 is the correct answer. Select the correct answer using the codes given. Only 1, only 2, only 3, 1 and 3. So the best option is only 3 is correct, which is option C. Sabko samajh mein aaya? Did everybody understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so this is how you need to analyze each question. Let's go to question number 2. Who can read question number 2? Who can read question number 2? Please, somebody, raise your hands. Not the one who has already read, another person. Sai? Sai, are you there? Sai? Ajinkya, are you there? Ajinkya Sonone?
May I read Rishikesh Tope?
Read better.
The Buddhist viewpoint implies.
Implies. Implies matlab kya hai? Aise bolte hai ki. That is the meaning of implies. Uska matlab hai ki. That is the meaning of implies.
Conservation should be given the highest consideration. Hydro projects are highly capital intensive. Oil is to be prepared since it does not produce ashes. Money economics should govern the choice of the energy source.
Okay. See, if you look at question number 2, I hope you remember the first thing that I have told you while discussing this. Bahut sara unwanted information dete hai, toh you don't have to get confused over it. अगर पैराग्राफ में नहीं बोले वाला कुछ स्टेटमेंट्स बोलते हैं तो इग्नोर इट. यू फोकस ऑन व्हाट इज देयर और व्हाट इज कनेक्टेड विद द गिवन पैराग्राफ, है ना. इधर हम देखते हैं तो हाइडल प्रोजेक्ट्स के बारे में बोलते हैं. हाइडल प्रोजेक्ट्स के बारे में इस पैराग्राफ में कुछ नहीं बोलते. ओके, कैपिटल इंटेंसिविटी के बारे में कुछ नहीं बोलते हाइडल प्रोजेक्ट्स का. सो दैट इज नॉट नेसेसरी. Oil is to be preferred since it does not produce ash. Oil and ash production. Oil se ash nahi aate, isliye oil production. Isse kuch nahi bolte is paragraph mein. Okay, Sai, got it. Next, money economics should govern the choice of energy resources. Money economics, energy resources ko dekhbhal karna hai. That is also बुद्धिस्ट व्यू पॉइंट नहीं है. बुद्धिस्ट का व्यू पॉइंट हम इधर बोलना है. बुद्धिस्ट इधर क्या बोला? बुद्धिस्ट व्यू पॉइंट क्या है? हम नॉन रिन्यूएबल रिसोर्स को एकदम अच्छा से देखभाल करना है, कंसर्व करना है, और उन्होंने कुछ नहीं बोला. सो विच इज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन हियर? हु कैन से द करेक्ट ऑप्शन? ऋषिकेश, विच विल बी द करेक्ट ऑप्शन?
A.
Very good. Option A. Because conservation should be given the highest consideration. Baki three statements, it is not connected with what Buddhist has said. Going to question number 3. Who can help me reading it? Those who have not read. Vedant, is your mic working? Kuntal, Chaitanya, Akshat, nobody can respond. Ashutosh, abhi nahi hai ke? Okay, Rameshwar, read it better. I think you are the only person, people, Ashutosh, Rishikesh. Only very few people respond through the mic, which is like very difficult.
Okay.
Yeah, read it better.
Third one, Buddhist economists are not in favor of A, economic development, B, world economy being governed by oil prices, C, using non-renewable sources indiscriminately, D, harnessing wind energy.
हाँ, okay, thank you बेटा. इधर question क्या है? Again Buddhist economics के बारे में. Buddhist economic question number 2 में बोल पूछा Buddhist economic economics क्या point देने वाला था? हमने बोला, उनको एक ही point है, resources एकदम सुरक्षित रूप से use करना है. इधर क्या है question? Buddhist economics are not in favor of. वो कुछ चीज के अगेंस्ट है. Which चीज से अगेंस्ट है? सिंपल है, उन्होंने एक ही बात बताया. सो बाकी कुछ पूछे तो वो कंसिडर भी नहीं करना है. लेट्स सी ऑल द ऑप्शंस. किस चीज के अगेंस्ट है? दैट इज व्हाट वी नीड टू सी. फर्स्ट वन, इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट. इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट वो बिल्कुल अगेंस्ट नहीं है. उन्होंने कुछ ही नहीं बताया पैराग्राफ में. देर आर नो सच इन्फॉर्मेशन लाइक दे आर अगेंस्ट इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट. सेकेंड वन, वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमिक बींग गवर्न्ड बाय ऑयल प्राइसेस. इट इज नॉट इवन मेंशन्ड इन द पैराग्राफ. So we don't know whether Buddhist is against this or towards this. Third one, using non-renewable resources indiscriminately. Indiscriminately means without consideration. Indiscriminately means without consideration. That is called. So non-renewable using किसी प्रकार use करने तो चलेगा. ऐसा है और non-renewable resources ऐसा किसी प्रकार use करते तो चलेगा. So they are definitely against this. Okay. Last one, harnessing wind energy. Wind energy ko include karke kuch. So that is also not mentioned in the paragraph. So which one is the correct answer, Rameshwar?
C option, using non-renewable resources indiscriminately.
Yes, it is very obvious. Very good. Wind non-renewable resources ekdam indiscriminate nahi use karna hai bolte. So this is the point they are against. Okay. Using non-renewable resource indiscriminately. Coming to the fourth question. In this passage, the author has tried to, okay, the author of this passage, what is he trying to show? To show that the modern economist is concerned only with cost, underline the need for conserving natural resources, differentiate between the two economic philosophies, explain the impact of oil on the world economy. See, these kind of questions can make you mark wrong. So ekdam dhyan dena hai. It looks simple. Kya hai question? Question ye hai ki is paragraph se, ye paragraph likhne walon ko hamare hriday mein, readers ke hriday mein kya what to say? What does he want to show or what does he want to actually convey? What message he wants to give by writing this paragraph? आपको क्या लग रहा है? क्या मैसेज आपके मन में आया इस पैराग्राफ रीड करने के बाद? हाँ, what is your decision after reading this paragraph, Rishikesh? Options में मत देखो, आप जनरली बोलो.
Natural resources बचाने चाहिए.
Yes, very good. हम सबको ऐसा ही लग रहा है ना? अभी तक हमने इससे इतने से नहीं सोचा. So natural resource का हम बचाने करें. So every reader, what will come to his mind as a first point after reading this? That is what the author implies. Now let's go through the options. Show that modern economics is kind of modern economics को हम blame करने के लिए ए paragraph लिखा. वो cost से पीछे है. वो blame करने के लिए. I don't think so. Second one, underline the need for conserving. Natural resource को बचाने के लिए, conserve करने के लिए एक message दे रहे. Third one, differentiate between two economy. वो Buddhist economy और normal economics का वो philosophies में क्या फर्क है वो दिखाने के लिए एक message लिखा. चार, explain the impact of oil on the oil का world economy में क्या impact है. Oil world economy कैसे affect करते हैं ये दिखाने के लिए ए पैराग्राफ लिखा. आपको क्या लग रहा है क्या दिखाने के लिए ए पैराग्राफ लिखा? ऑप्शंस
मैम, ऑप्शन बी, अंडरलाइन द नीड ऑफ कंजर्विंग नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज.
वेरी गुड. वो नेचुरल रिसोर्सिंग हम कैसे परीक्षण करना है वो दिखाने के लिए उन्होंने एक पैसेज दिया. ओके, सो दिस इज योर प्रीवियस ईयर एनडीए क्वेश्चन. सो दिस इज हाउ यू विल गेट passage in your NDA. It is comparatively easy. Some passage can be hard. All right? Everybody understood? Can you please take down the question and the answers? I mean, screenshot will do. Please take the screenshot of this page. Fast. Done? Is it done? Have you taken the screenshot, Rameshwar?
Yes, ma'am.
Have you taken the screenshot, Rishikesh? No reply. Anyways, I want you to start reading.
Yes, passage. Ma'am.
Yeah. Start reading passage 2 and tomorrow we will discuss the answers because we have only 5 minutes left. So start reading passage 2 and tomorrow when you come, I'm giving it as a homework. Note down all the words that you don't know. Exactly like how we did today. Pehle, difficult words, meaning learn karna hai. Then we should understand the paragraph. Then we will go to the question. Okay? Okay, Sai, just go through this. And difficult words, each line when you read and when you come across a word which is not known to you, write it down in your notebook then and there. Okay? Do that. Fast. Two minutes. Okay, which is the first word that is unknown to you? Rishikesh Tupay?
Ma'am, affluent.
Ah, very good. I knew it would be. Okay, so affluent is nothing but wealthy. You know the meaning of wealthy?
Ma'am, shayad se ameer ya fir.
Ha, yes. Great deal of money. Okay? Wealthy means great deal of money. They will be having land or money or cars or being that. That is called wealthy. What is the next word, Rameshwar?
Ma'am, indulge.
Okay, indulge means to get into. Indulge means to get into. To involve oneself in. Wo activity mein hum engaged hota hai, bolte hai na? We will get into or we will be entertained or engaged in. Engaged in is the correct word. To get into or engaged in. Okay, Chaitanya, I see that. Monotonous. Monotonous chores means हर दिन सेम प्रकार की सेम फॉर्म दैट इज कॉल्ड मोनोटोनस. सब मोनोटोनस, उसमें कुछ डिफरेंस नहीं है. हर दिन उठाता है, देन ये करता है, करता है, कुछ चेंज नहीं है. विदाउट एनी चेंज दैट इज कॉल्ड एज मोनोटोनस. विदाउट एनी चेंज. लीशर सबको पता है, लीशर ब्रेक, ब्रेक टाइम. लीशर टाइम इज ब्रेक.
कॉन्जेनियल
okay the other words since we have running out since we are running out of time. Hope you have taken the screenshot, so that is your duty to be done by tomorrow. So note down the words, note its meaning, and we will discuss the answer and the paragraph tomorrow. Okay, bye everyone, bye, God bless you, bye.